control panel. It's Aqualink RS. It's a Jandy control panel. You've got your, when you open it up, you've got your auto service and timeout. The auto is your handheld remote, your PDA, and your programming. Once you hit the bottom button below there, that'll scroll out of auto into service mode. And then whenever you go to service mode, that pulls your program offline. If you turn your PDA on, it'll tell you no operations allowed. You've got three modes, auto, service, and timeout. Whenever it's in service or timeout, you have full function of the keyboard. The difference between service and timeout is service mode. Somebody has to manually push the button to get to scroll out of service mode. In other words, if you put it in service and hit the filter pump, it would run until you came back and scrolled into timeout or hit the button for the filter pump to go off. Whenever you go to timeout, that actually starts counting down backwards from 3 hours. You can hit your filter pump, it'll run for 3 hours, and then it'll go back to auto. So typically when you're doing your pool maintenance on the or your pump maintenance over at the equipment pad, you would want to go to timeout. That way, if you forget to scroll back to auto, 3 hours later it goes back to auto. On the keypad, you've got filter pump, which is drives the pool or the spa. You've got your cleaner, which is the booster pump for the players. We've got your pool lights, your spillway, your air blower, which is the bubbler for the spa, and then we have your waterfall pumps. And then on the far right hand side, you have a heater button, and then we've got your pool mode. You've got your valves over here, the pool, spa, main drain, or spa drain, spa fill. Basically those can be controlled with your PDA. And then, so as far as there is a 9-volt battery back here, you want to replace that every 6 months. That'll, if you ever lose power, that'll prevent you from having to set your time and date and reprogramming your equipment. And then last but not least, at the control panel, we have your GFCI. If your lights aren't working, this is the first thing to check. If you have an outdoor kitchen area, your refrigerator's typically, that outdoor kitchen circuit is also directed to this. So if your refrigerator's not working or your pool or spa light's not working, there's a test and reset button on this plug. You want to make sure that it's reset, and then this is a working duplex plug. You can use it for anything that you want to plug into it. There's also, with this system, you have an air temp sensor, which is tucked in below here. We also have a water temp sensor that is installed on the plumbing, but this air temp sensor is for freeze protection. Whenever you get to 35 or below, we can dictate when we want the pump to come on, but whenever it gets 35 or below, the filter pump will kick on and run until it gets above 35. Its main purpose is for freeze protection. It will give you an air temperature. Typically during the summer, once the brick or the house heats up, the temperature is elevated. But its main purpose is for freeze protection.